TCU comes out with an I formation. Gruber gets it on the inside. Davis tackles him for a loss on the play. And it's the All-American who came away with the tackle.
Yo, you can add this one to his scouting video. That's a great play.
The offense faces another third down as they line it up. Gruber, the lone back, looking. Neal swings it. And he's got it. Coming the other way now. He's got some blocker. The 10. He's all the way home. Touchdown. And they line up for the point after. He splits the uprights for the extra point. And with 4 minutes to go in the second quarter, our score, Texas 21, TCU nothing. Texas, get this one off.
The quarterback has to get that interception out of his hands. He can't be scared to keep firing away in this game, and the defense is clearly up front.
The D-line shifts over. Gruber takes it up the middle. They bring him down for a loss on the throw. The defensive end came through to put him away.
Nice job of utilizing his athletic ability to get in there and then make a short tackle.
The horn calls. Come out the shotgun. Look at the throw. He steps up. He's going right. It's complete. At the 40. Across midfield. At the 40. At the 30. To the 20. To the 10. Touchdown! And the halfback just exploded for the huge play and the touchdown.
If he keeps playing like this, he'll be playing with the big boys on Sunday.
And let me tell you something, Kirk. Nowadays, the pros are always looking for running backs who can run and catch. And this guy can do it all.
PAT. Over 3 minutes remain in the second quarter, and the score is Texas 21, TCU 7. Williams looks ready to kick this one off. And it's a short kickoff. Higgins takes it to 12. Keep two hands on the ball after their last drive.
But if you start thinking too much about fumbling, you become less effective as a runner. Still go out there and play their game.
3-man front defensively. Higgins hits the handoff. Breaks one. Miller with a takedown at the 33-yard line. A nice pickup of about 8 yards.
Tell your quarterback to stand in there and make a play.
They line up at the 33. Second and two coming up here. The Longhorn set up in the gun. Lee drops the throw. Here's a little bump fake. Rolling out to the right side. He's got a throw in a hurry. Now it opens and he's going to run. And he scrambles for the first down.
He was looking downfield, but nothing was available. He just tucked it in and got a first down. Nice to see.
First and 10, ball on the 36. The defense sets up with five defensive linemen. Lee to the air on first down. He fires this one.
What a great play call there. They came right out of the gate and attacked the defense in the air on first down.
It was a really nice game on the pass. Let's see if they go back to the air again on the next play.
It's first and 10, ball on the 49. 3-man front defensively. Lee looking to throw on first down. He unloads it. Into the tight end. Oh, brings him down at the 32. And God, you can just feel the momentum building in this one. That's The Longhorns line up in high formation. They bring him down at the 28. He picks up 4 yards on the carry.
Heavy submersion here and try to confuse the defense.
They line up at the 28. 7-6 coming up here. Lee is back in the gun. Give it off here. And wait, that was him at the 27. Brown picks up a yard on the play. Lee lines up in the shotgun. Brown again. Gets pressure tackle. He's tackled. It's another run. And a big run on third down.
Good job there by the offensive line, allowing the run to get some good yardage.
Lee, as you know, anytime you can move the ball like this, you're putting a lot of pressure on that defense.
Lee, back in the gun. He's looking to pass. Over the middle. And if you see him, fellas, he's really out for an outstanding start in this football game.
Hey, if he continues at this pace, he may go for 500 yards.
I'll tell you what, this guy is so much fun to watch when he gets into a rhythm like this.
Run the 1 yard line. It's second down. Brown takes it up the middle. He finally blocks and rams right into the end zone.
He's a good offensive line for that one. He's able to stay for you think I'd want you to go for two here? No way.
They're setting up for the PAT. And he takes on the extra point. What's the amount remaining in the second quarter? Four is Texas 28, TCU 7. Texas gets set to kick this all away. Taylor fields it for three. At the 30, he sends her out. Tyler with the best he's got down the field again. Their last drive, they move the ball very well, especially through the air on their way to that touchdown. We've got a first and 10. Ball in the 37. Neal lines up in the shotgun. Drop back to pass. He steps up. Neal delivers. And that one's called incomplete. Jenkins was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up second down. From their own 36-yard line. The second down and 10 to go. They line up in the shotgun. Neal steps back to pass. Throws it to the outside. And caught. And he's tackled at the 43. Short pass there, and they get a moderate gain. They line up in line. Neal drops back. Neal passes. He's taken down at the 43-yard line. TCU calls a timeout. First and 10. Ball at the 43-yard line. Three wideouts to the right side. Neal steps back to pass. Steps up. Neal goes down to the sack. And TCU will take a timeout. That's their second half. From the gun, Neal back to throw. Throwing left. That one got hand up.
That's just good defense right there, Kirk.
It was, Kirk. But you know what? It's all the action. Anytime you're out there on defense and the pass is within arm's length away, knock it down.
Good third down. From the gun. Neal at the pass. Looks. Throws it to the outside. Good coverage and it's intercepted. And they turn it over right before the half.
Well, this really hurts them here. They're trying to cut into that lead before they got into the showers for halftime, but unfortunately, this turnover will still lead them down as they get into the locker room.
When you press for time, you've got to make sure you clear a stop the clock without using a timeout here.
They'll set up shot at the 30-yard line. They line up in a double tight set.
I agree with you 100%. You can't really key on any one guy.
He gets it up, and it's through the upright. And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. He's all the way down to the 15. Second half adjustments definitely needed in this one. Our score, Texas 31, TCU 7.